And that was Vaccinations for Thomas Mann by Tim Pecker and Daniel Lipitan off their collaborative album Instrumental Tourist. I was listening to that album a lot recently. I was kind of like bored a few days ago, so I was like, you know, I'll just put on the album. And it was almost hypnotic. I guess that'll be the best way to describe that track on the album in total. I mean, I love Daniel Lipitan, Mastermind, One of the Tricks More Than Ever, and then Tim Hecker, one of my favorite ambient artists. I also listen to that album, Raven Death, 1972, a lot. Great album. But also Daniel Lipitan, One of the Tricks More Than Ever. I was listening to Replica earlier this morning on this way to college day on the bus. You know, I fall asleep listening to music, so I was like, all right, I'm just playing Replica. I was like, it put me in this weird sleep trance. I don't know how to describe it, but it was like, I had a really vivid and weird dream. It was beautiful. It was really nice. Yeah. And you know, I think it's a really great, beautiful ambient track in total. Good afternoon, listeners. Coffee Noise. I'm your host, DJ Marlin. And if you can't believe it, it's Tuesday once again. How are we doing out there, listeners? Today, it is the 19th November, 2024. Right now it is 4:07 in Edinburgh, Texas, wherever you're all listening to. Somewhere probably in the valley. I don't know. I don't really know much outside of world geography, and I really did so well in that class. Although once, I think I was in middle school, I did a world geography thing for UIL, and I got fourth place. I don't know how, because I don't know anything about world geography, but I don't know. I was lucky. I don't know. Kind of cool thing about it. Let's see here. It's only like a few more weeks before the end of the semester, and only like 20-something days before I graduate on the 13th, I think? Yeah, 13th. But yeah, Friday, 10 in the morning for the Liberal Arts College. So for any of those who are graduating, I hope to see you there. And, you know, best of luck to us all if you're going to go back to grad school like me, or you're going to pursue your future career now, you know, great for you, you know. You worked hard, you know, reap the rewards or something like that. I don't know. I don't really know that much. Let's go a quick look at the weather right now. Let's see here. Right now in the city of Edinburgh, we are looking, it's currently 85 degrees with a high of 87 and a low of 62. This morning was kind of like fresh, so I brought a flannel with me. And then when I got to the bus, I was like, oh, it's not even cold anymore. It's already warm. Yet I still brought the flannel. My girlfriend currently has a flannel with me, so she finds it comfortable. For me, it was like, I don't know what to do with it right now. But, you know, whatever. I thought we were going to be a chance of some cooler weather, but apparently not. Apparently for the next 2 days, it might be in the high 70s, so I guess you want to say that's a cool front? Not really a cool front that I would call it, but, you know, it's like, you know, I'll take it. You know, I'm not going to say no to cooler weather. The high 70s, is that really the best we can do? I mean, I would much prefer maybe like a low 70, high 60s. Perfect weather for this time of year. But I guess we can't have what we all want. Or something like that. Anyways, Thanksgiving is next week. So for all those who are eating, you know, have fun. If you're going to deep fry a turkey, like, know the buoyancy levels. Because you see the videos online where people, like, they fill it to the brim with oil. You're open over open flame, and then they dump the bird in it. Like, you're gonna cause a grease fire like that. So you might have a cooked turkey, but you also might have a cooked ham. So if you're gonna deep fry a turkey, one, you shouldn't do that because it just tastes nasty. I've had it once. It's like if I want a greasy food, I get myself greasy chicken. I get myself deep fried chicken. Me personally, I don't think anyone should deep fry a turkey. It doesn't make any sense. Like, just put it in the oven. It's not that hard. But you know, I digress. Anyways, let's get into the next track right now. This is Salem from their album Fires in Heaven. It's like a known for their witch house music in the early 2010s, but yeah, let's get into it. Yellow. And that was River by the UK collective Salt. Kind of like a jazzy sound. I think that album, I think it's pronounced 11, if I'm correct, off the top of my head. I think it was released in 2022. It was probably like my second or third semester of college when that album came out. It was like collective albums was that, along with the four other albums that came out all together at once. I think it came out on a one day thing. Interesting way of announcing and then subsequently releasing the album. So it wasn't like one day this album, the other day this. It was kind of like just all at once, which I found attractive. I guess that would be the best way to describe it. I don't really know how to put it in better words, but how would I say that? Yeah, I would go as far to say it was very attractive in the manner how they released the albums. Interesting choice of words there. Let's see, talk about some basic music news on top of my head. The band Squid, the UK band Squid, is releasing their third album, titled Cowards. It's going to be released in February of next year, February 5th, released via Warp Records. So I'm definitely interested in seeing how they're doing that. And then Cameron Winters, the lead singer of the New York-based band Geese, to which I love their sophomore album, 3D Country, is going to release his debut solo album. I mean, he released, like, a few singles. I really like them, like, his weird videos on Instagram, live performances. Like, he really plays with the whole brain rot thing. Like, there's one video of him performing, and the bottom has, like, Subway Surfers or something playing. I don't know. It's kind of funny. I think it's, like, post-ironic humor, if that's even a word. I think it's a word. I want to say it's a word. I'll have to figure that out. I'm not that good at figuring things like that out, but yeah, I just really like that track. I like both the tracks I played, but I think I personally prefer the Salt track more. I mean, I love the band Salem. I mean, they were listening to their first album. I think I was, 16. So nice. Well, it was kind of like a weird experience. Like, whoa, what is this? It was like, it wasn't like anything I ever heard. And then when they released their sophomore album, like a decade after their debut album, I was like, oh, this feels so great. I mean, they already have a few mixtapes out. Like, there's they have their mixtape, Stay Down. I remember it has a remix of Frank Ocean's track. What's that track called? It's off Blonde, but I can't remember the top of my head. I'll try to remember for you listeners, but, wow, I forgot the name of it. Isn't that something? Not the best. I'm not that good at remembering. But you know what? Let's get into the next track right now. This is Scott Walker's track, It's Raining Today. All right, listeners, we're back. It is 4:32 in the afternoon. How are we doing? You listened to two tracks, It's Raining Today by Scott Walker off his, his third album, Scott 3, I think that was called. Please, and early 70s, I want to say. I can't remember. And then the second track you heard was That Finger on Your Temple, The Barrel of My Ray Gun by Stars of the Lead. Very calm, 5-minute ambient track. I've been listening to that album, Decline, or Five Mountain Decline, Stars of the Lead a lot to fall asleep to. It's personally one of my favorite albums, and it's a grail for me to get it. I do want to collect all the Star Lives albums on vinyl to have in my collection. I don't have any of them. I used to have a CD of it, but I traded that one for, I forget what I traded in for. Looking back on it, maybe I shouldn't have done that. And also I went the whole like deep dive and started living side projects after the death of Brian McBride. I believe it was last year or so. The album, what's that album called? I believe it's their second album, if I'm correct. There's that one track, I Will Surround You. I was, like, so deeply enamored by that track. And then, the previous album before it, or from their client, it was The Tired Sounds of Stars of Lead. That album was, like, really difficult for me to hear. It's very emotional. I mean, it's still an ambient album, but it's like, I don't know, something about it just really, like, strikes a chord. That's the best I could say. Let's get to the next track right now. This is Perfect Day by Lou Reed. I've been getting into Lou Reed a lot. Also the Velvet Underground in general, but the solo work of Lou Reed's been really on my list, so.
That was the ambient track, 1380, Standing Guard Around the Side of Your Bed by the band Silver Mountain Zion, released, I believe, in the early 2000s.
It was one of the side projects of for Emmanuel Minnick after the around decade-long hiatus of the American post-rock band Godspeed You Black Emperor, which I've been listening to a lot. I was listening to Mount Zion's discography. There's this album. It's a long title name. Oh, I forgot what it was. What was the name of this album called again? I honestly forgot the name of it. Silly me. He has left us alone, but shafts of light sometimes grace the corner of our rooms. Slightly poetic. Some would say it's just a bunch of Spanish words put together, but I find it very calming. What is calming is finally the Giants have actually benched Daniel Jones, which is finally, like, come on, dude. We've been in 2-8 so far. It's like, we're not going to make it to the Super Bowl. We're not going to make it to the Super Bowl. But, you know, what else is new? I'm going to say it. Having Daniel Jones as the Giants quarterback is worse than the extinction of the human race in a few billion years. I'm just going to put that out. Extinction of the human race? Nah, it's not so bad when comparison to having Daniel Jones as our quarterback. Where he's going to be replaced by Tommy DeVito. So, Italians of America, rejoice, for you have an Italian playing for the Giants. I still do like Tommy DeVito's playing style. Hopefully he's able to like help out the Giants win a couple games, but even then, like, we're the chance of us making it any further is pretty slim. Why did I have to be a Giants fan? Why was it when I was a kid I liked the colors, and it so happened I turned out to like the team? Why does my team have to suck? I have no idea, but, you know, whatever. I'm not a Giants. I am a Giants fan. I'm not a Cowboys fan. I don't like the Cowboys. I make fun of the Cowboys a lot, especially because my coworker, he's a Cowboys fan. A few of them are Cowboys fans. So every time the Cowboys lose, it's like a little bit of me rejoices. But then I look at my team, it's like, oh, we're horrible. We failed again. For this week's final track, I decided to go for something, I wouldn't say experimental, but something a bit loud. This is Swans with the track Oxygen off the album, To Be Kind. Yeah, let's get into it. All right, listeners, and we are back. It is 4:58. About turn about be 4:59. About 15 seconds. We're gonna wrap this show up for this week. Let's see here. For this week, we play a total of 8 tracks for y'all. And as always, this playlist will be available on both Apple Music and Spotify. You can find it there by following me on Instagram at Watford2003. I decided to go for a different style. We started with ambient music. We kind of did ambient music, post rock. Singer-songwriter, I guess you could say experimental, electronic, and then soul-based music, and then, pretty much describes the entire this week's music choice. I'm your host, DJ Marlin, and this was Coffee Noise, and let's see, final ideas before I let y'all go. Peanut butter jelly sandwiches are pretty good. You know, if you have it, make one. Kind of nostalgic, you know what I'm saying? Anyways, I'm DJ Marlin. Remember, you're listening to Vicala Radio, the Valley's Only Sensation. All right. Bye-bye.